there, Stevie?
I've got our muck blocks. Can you see that?
Muck? Oh, look it. That's its actual name. Yep. Muck block.
Yep. We're going to put each of these at one of the diffusers to hopefully get the muck on the bottom lessening.
Four of them? That's enough for our pond?
It's actually a bit of overkill.
Sweet.
Yes. And then we've got the liquid bacteria that we're going to be putting down there. They already have down at the side of the
I can't wait.
We're going to work on the beneficial bacteria today.
We're going to do that first and then the muck blocks, or the muck blocks first?
Everything all at once.
Oh,
they're
okay.
They're all bacteria and enzymes.
Okay. Ooh. I just want to see what that is there. Pond bacteria reduces muck. Yeah. Okay, we're hating on muck today.
We have no idea really how old the pond is, but we have evidence, aerial photos back to the 1930s, and the pond was here. So it's well over 100 years old. It is completely circled with farmland, and all of the watershed is farms, pastures predominantly. And our property was all horse pasture land for decades and decades and decades. We have talked with people who rode their horses through the property back in the 70s and 80s and would water their horses, and the horses would just wade in and do what horses do. Needless to say, we've got plenty of nutrients, gobs and gobs of phosphorus. Every time it storms, more rushes in. So the bacteria, it is a temporary fix at best, but we want to see what it can do. There's a lot of controversy in adding bacteria, because one might ask, isn't there bacteria in this natural pond? Absolutely there is, unless of course something has killed all of the bacteria. And that certainly could have been true when it did not have the aerators. It was kind of a cesspool that would be a stagnant swamp more than a pond.
So let's just get some background information.
Yes.
How long have those aerators been in the pond?
They've been in the pond a year now.
Okay.
And
they run 24/7?
Yep, they run 24/7, 365. They ran all winter. So we're going to see if we notice anything around them in terms of the muck layer.
So here are the two different things we're going to put in the pond today. And my question, Steve, is what is the difference between these two things?
Not a whole lot. One is going to be suspended in the water.
That's the muck block?
Nope, that is the liquid.
Okay.
Bacteria mix that will just disperse throughout the pond and chew up, if you will, the nutrients that are in the actual pond water.
Okay.
The muck blocks, they will sit at the bottom, and they have a time release, and the block is just going to slowly dissolve over about a month. I did not go at all with the most expensive options, largely because the bacteria are the bacteria, right? And this is just, even this is high priced natural bacteria that, again, we could have cultivated in the pond. We're literally trying to just shock it with an overload of bacteria so that the nutrient level goes down. So there's what the muck block looks like. We'll take it out of the plastic. I'd say it reminds me a lot of a salt lick. And but it stinks.
Oh, that smells terrible.
Yeah, there's the bacteria.
Woo! Nelly.
Nelly.
Whew. So, all right, hurry up, dunk that in the pond.
That's an important note, though, is that since we did the aeration, the pond doesn't smell bad at all. Even when you dig up the muck at the shoreline, yes, it smells like decaying, leaves, but the
aerators have definitely kicked the natural bacteria going, and we're getting a much healthier environment.
So we're gonna leave all the rest of them in the plastic.
Yes, we are. I am not going to have any of the rest of them opened until I'm right over the diffusers. Then I will slice it with my trusty Kershaw knife here. And
not a sponsor, but we'd be willing to talk to them.
Yeah, they are fabulous knives. So yeah, I would love that. So we're going to keep those as they are, and then we'll put them in the poke boat and go.
I want to see if this smells.
Well, I'm sure it does. Yeah, kind of like rotten egg-ish.
Oh.
Not nearly as bad as the
blocks. Not nearly as bad as the blocks, but still.
All right.
I don't know if my pond were like super close to my house. I don't know if I'd want to use those blue blocks, quite honestly.
Yeah, well, they're going to be at the bottom of the pond, fortunately.
That's a good point.
I'm just opening these so I don't have to do it while I'm floating around in the poke boat. And so each one of these does an acre. And our pond currently, at this point, is closer to 3.5 acres. The deepest area I'll confirm, but I think that the deepest areas now are 4.5 feet rather than the 7.5 to 8 feet that they were last year. So that's it.
Okay, so I have a question.
Yeah.
How is this stuff here?
Yeah.
Any different from the horse poo that got us into this mess to begin with?
Yeah, you know what? The bacteria that would be in, like, horse manure,
mm-hmm.
Is very similar, quite honestly, and is likely swimming around in our waters.
We should have just gone to our neighbors and said, can we borrow your horses for a couple days?
That is legitimately, if you read about bacteria for ponds, that's actually what people will talk about. Or they'll say, listen, you want billions of bacteria to have a handful of soil. There's billions and billions and billions of bacteria. Chuck this in your pond, right?
So why are we doing this?
We are doing this because potentially, the amount of bacteria that we're putting in all at once can, again, as I have said before, drive down the current nutrients. And it's really an experiment. See what we get from it.
Okay.
Yep. Wanted to get a quick shot of the poke boat. It is manufactured down south and actually is from a company that makes military grade airline or airplane parts. And though it is not much to look at, it is really, really a solid, stable build. It's used mostly for photography and hunting. This one is fiberglass, weighs less than 30 pounds. It's just a great, great fishing rig. Here I'm at one of the diffusers. You can see it bubbling away. And you can also see the greenness of the water with the algae bloom. And then the duckweed there